the dimensional modulator on the blink and now air in the pipes.
Doctor! Doctor!
Oh, it's you two. Whatever's the matter? Look, if they don't have Crispy Duck...
Doctor, open the door now!
All right. Hold on to your wonton.
Crispy Duck and egg fried rice, is it?
I think you'd better shut the door, Doctor. I give up. We come to the Lao Dynasty for a nice bowl of wonton and crispy duck and exactly how did you manage to upset the locals?
Let's just say the Lao Palace turned out not to be a restaurant.
Of course not. It's a palace, which would explain the Imperial Guards hurling spears, I suppose. Maybe we should make this a takeaway. I hope you left Emperor Chanzo a good tip.
Yeah, use more salt.
Maybe just need some new valves.
Doctor, what's happening here?
Don't panic, just a bump. Hardly a scrape, really.
What with?
Another spaceship!
Oh! That's new. Pretty, don't you think?
Is it real? I mean, is it really there?
Of course it is. It's a dimensional lesion. I'll show you. You see? It's a portal.
But what's it doing in the TARDIS?
Caused by the impact with that alien ship, I'd say. Rory, pass me the sonic, will you? And don't throw it!
Sorry.
Duh.
Interdimensional pressure differential. No worries. You can go and get it.
Me?
I can't go, obviously. I have to stay here and make sure the lesion doesn't close on you.
Close on me?
Hurry up. What's the doctor without his sonic screwdriver? Inscrutable. Go. Unstable.
One day, I'll be the one to stay safely in the TARDIS. Oh, it's always me that has to do these things.
Right, Amy, we're going to have to fix this lesion properly. We need a dimensional equalizer.
And have you got one?
No, of course I haven't. There's no such thing.
Well, that's useful then.
But I'm the doctor. I can make one, can't I? I just need a Cardanium Vortex Tuner and a Zardak Hollowfield Trap.
And have you got those?
Of course I have, in the drawing room. Now, hurry up and find them and put them together for me.
Now, where can I find the hollow doodah and the vortex, whatchamacallit? Okay, so, thing A connects to thing B, sort of, and, hey presto! Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you thing C.
Oh, good work, Pop. Efficiency. That's what I like to see.
Well, I try.
Works pretty well, even if I do say so myself.
Doctor? What's this?
It's a subtemporal distress signal from another ship.
Oh, the one we, bumped?
Honestly, it was nothing more than a ding. Well, we'd better go and take a look. Exchange insurance details. Ah, smell that. London.
Oh, it smells like something died.
Well, of course, it's 1605. You don't think they got bubonic plague because everything was clean, do you?
Bubonic plague?
Are you worried? I'm not worried. I'm a doctor, you're a nurse. Besides, 1605 was a quiet year for the plague. Only around 400 people died from it.
So we're in London, but where?
Isn't it obvious? Underground!
I was hoping for something more specific.
You want something specific? I'll be specific. We've got a problem.
How did that get here?
I'm afraid we brought it here. It's a byproduct of our scrape with that alien ship.
Oh, a scrape now, is it? I thought it was just a bump.
Point is, this probably isn't the only one, and they're being generated by the proximity of the TARDIS and whatever we bumped into, which is fine. Only we can't go until we've found that ship, and meanwhile this lesion is highly unstable, and if I'm not careful it could swallow up the whole of London.
I'll get you the equaliser thing.
It's going to take a bit more than that. So, you two try and find that ship while I deal with this. And remember, the Lao Dynasty was 400 years ago. That's when that ship crashed. Wherever we are, this is probably built on top of it.
Okay, Doctor.
And Pons, be careful.
Time is nearly upon us. Soon, the false king will be dead, and England will rejoice again in God's pleasure.
A great day for all. Now, come. We have business with our brothers.
They sound suspicious. Let's see where they're heading.
Oh, these old creaking corridors make some noises that would make the dead shiver.
Do you think we can trust everyone?
We were all chosen because we can be trusted. Do not doubt that. I trust you left your house in order? God is on our side in this endeavor, but even his work may take a heavy toll. Who is to say which of us will see the morning?
I did as you asked.
Good. Your family deserve the future we will bring them.
Another rat! I hate the filthy things. This town is infested.
Ease your fear, my friend. The rats were born to the sewers, but there is far worse vermin in the halls of the monarch. But soon we will destroy them, and the king rat upon which they all depend.
Then pray to God they take these unholy brethren with them.
There must be some way to find out what these dodgy characters are up to.
Shoo!
There is something about you that those rats find irresistible.
Get lost!
We ought to find out where these guys are heading.
Strange. That torch, it's flickering like air's rushing past.
Lady Winters, your beauty illuminates even these dank surroundings.
Enough of your flattery, Catesby. Is all set?
Aye, milady. It is. Tomorrow the Protestant king will come to open his parliament above us, and will be welcomed by 41 kegs of gunpowder.
Oh my god. We're under the Houses of Parliament. It's 1605, and this is the gunpowder plot.
It will be my honour to light the fuse.
And he must be
Guy Fawkes.
You and your men have done well, Catesby.
It is God's work to remove this imposter king. Our plans were in motion before you joined us, my lady. But your presence has brightened our toils.
Who the hell is that cheesy creep?
Sir Robert Catesby, I think. He was the brains. The thing I want to know is, who's she?
Lady Winters.
There wasn't any Lady Winters. The plotters were all men.
We have all been given a paper detailing the group's final meeting tonight. We shall rendezvous as planned.
We've got to find out what's really going on here. We need that bit of paper.
You create a distraction. I'll grab the paper. I'll wait by that door. If you can create a distraction to bring them out of the other one, I can try and get that paper.
Is going on here?
Guido, the rats! They're everywhere! The filthy devils!
Fool. Ignore them. We have a job to do. Come on.
Milady, I know we do what we do for God and for England, but I want you to know, if I'm not destined to survive these proceedings, I shall carry the memory of your sweet face to heaven.
All I ask, Fawkes, is that you raise that place above us to ruin.
Did you see that? Her eyes glowed.
We need to tell the doctor about this.
We need to get our hands on that document. Right, take him the paper and tell him what's going on. I'm going to keep an eye on Lady Gaga.
Okay, just be careful, all right?
You too. Let's see where you're headed, Green Lady, with your glowing eyes. Where are you going? What are you doing over there? Where are you going?
Right, gizmos, do your thing. Excellent. Less than excellent.
Amy?
Oh my God!
Amy! Amy!
Thanks, Doctor, but now what's the plan?
Plan? I'm sorry, saving you from being fried to a crisp is as far as I got. A plan. Interesting idea.
Ah, yes! Sensitive to high-frequency noise. Well done, Pond.
Ha-ha! Fingernails on a chalkboard. No one can stop that.
After her! Come on!
She did it again!
I hate shapeshifters. They never play fair in a chase.
What was that?
A Rutan. I'm afraid that must have been what we bumped into. A Rutan ship.
So what do they want with Guy Fawkes?
Guy Fawkes? Guido?
We saw him. Me and Rory. Down in the cellars. Those cellars are under Parliament. This is 1605, Doctor. November 5th, 1605.
Yes, yes, I know all that.
You know?
Remember the 5th of November? How could I forget? What I don't know is why Rutan would be getting pally with them. And the real problem is that it might not just be Rutans. The thing about aliens is, they're never as careful as they think they are. People notice stuff, all sorts of stuff. Odd stuff, strange stuff. Come on, Pond, let's go and find the word on the smelly street. Ugh.
Well, Doctor? Doctor, what's wrong with him?
He looks catatonic. No doubt a result of encountering the lesion.
What, you mean the lesion did this to him?
No, his brain did this to him. This is a London town crier in 1605. His brain has no point of reference for something like this. He's never seen a temporal portal before, so when his brain can't cope, it closes down.
Sir, I must thank you. This strange wonder has me bewitched. It is like some gateway to another realm.
Tell me what you know about these gateways.
Little enough. I went looking for the truth behind the wild stories that young Charlie told me. And then, before I know what, a great many of these gateways appeared about the streets. And it worries me greatly.
Charlie? Who's Charlie?
A young orphan who came to me with stories of travelling through these strange gateways to the house of the Green Lady.
So what about this Green Lady? Who is she?
I haven't seen her myself, but everyone talks of an apparition of a well-to-do lady, beautiful to look at, who wanders the streets after dark. She is dressed in green, and some say her eyes glow like emeralds lit with cold fire. Others say she appears and disappears before your eyes.
You said there were more of these gateways. Where are they?
There are two others I know of. I can take you to them if you wish.
Okay, Amy, I'm going to go with this Sterling fellow and see if I can deal with the other legions round here before they tear London apart.
And what about me?
See if you can find out more about this Charlie chappy. Chat to people. Get the goss. You're good at that.
I'm looking for Charlie. Have you seen him?
You stay away from me. I ain't talking to no strangers. You might give me the plague.
Good evening, miss. I am Alice Flowers, purveyor of fine herbal remedies.
Hello, Alice. My name's Amy. I don't suppose you've noticed anything out of the ordinary going on, have you?
Always, my dear. There's never a dull moment in London town.
I'm looking for Charlie. Have you seen him?
Indeed I have, miss. I saw him only last night, white as a sheet and soaked to the skin. Looked like he'd been scared off to death. Young Barnaby is a close friend. He may know of his whereabouts.
What remedies do you have for the plague?
For the plague, I make posies which can mask the poison vapours and prevent its spread. For other ailments, I make salves and poultices that you apply to the body.
Posies? You mean flowers?
A posy is a small bag containing a mixture of three herbs. Bring me bergamot, comfrey and lavender and I can make you one. Need to mix them all up and crush them a little to release the perfume. There we go! One sweet posy for your delicate, pretty young nose.
Thank you.
Highburn Tree is an excellent example of humanity's cruelty to one another. Retribution for perceived crimes is a universal constant, and hanging is one of the longest surviving methods of dispatching convicted criminals. The Highburn Tree was the humorous name given to the gallows that stood in central London during the early 17th century.
Told you, miss, I ain't talking to no strangers what might have the plague.
Here, take this posy. Can we talk now?
Thanks, miss. Maybe you ain't got the plague, but you got a downright strange accent, and you can't be too careful. What do you want to know?
Hey, I hear you're a friend of Charlie. Can, you help me find him?
I don't know where he is. Last I saw him, he reckoned he'd found a way into the Green Lady's house. Said something about some big tunnels near Parliament, and treasure there up for grabs. I don't know how right he was, but he was desperate to find a way of helping Annie. Asked me to look after her while he was away. I ain't seen him since.
You're an orphan. That's got to be so hard. How do you manage?
Well, I've done all right. When my mom and dad passed on with the sickness, I got sent to the parish. It's what happens to kids when their folks go. But there's nothing for me there. So I ran away and ended up on the streets. But I'm quick. People never catch me. So I'll make enough to get by.
A young boy like you shouldn't be pickpocketing and stealing. It's wrong, and it's dangerous.
Of course it's dangerous. And I'll be in trouble if the watch catch me. I'm fit to work, you see. So if they find me, it'll be a flogging, then sent back to my parish. The poor laws ain't kind to folks like me. But they've got to catch me first, haven't they?
That's awful. You're too young to be living on the streets. You should be at school. Isn't there one you could go to?
School, miss? Not me.
But you've got to have an education. There must be somewhere you can learn how to read and write.
I ain't got the money for no school, miss. Like my folks couldn't send me to petty school when I was young. Anyway, letters and stuff. They're for the toffs and churchmen. And even if I did get into one of them free grammar schools, how would I make money to eat and stuff?
So, let me get this straight. Green Lady's so-called house. Big tunnel near Parliament, missing Charlie. I hope the doctor can make sense of all this.
Here we go, sir. It's around that corner. Excuse me if I don't accompany you. After my previous experience, I have little stomach for sorcery.
Very well done, sir. I must say I'm impressed with your skill with the arcane arts. Now follow me to the next one.
All right. What do you want?
It's all right, Margaret. This here is a man on the King's business.
Oh, I don't care if it's the risen Lord himself. Get lost!
Hello! I need to get into your yard. Can you let me in?
Get lost! I don't know you from Adam.
I apologise for Margaret's uncooperative behaviour. Perhaps you could grease her palm in some way.
I think this might help.
Sorry, sir. Sorry. Right away. Come in, sir. Welcome. Doctor, there you are.
Of course I'm here. I'm having way too much fun to be anywhere else. Now, what do we know about Charlie?
They say he's been following Winters to her house.
Her house? Interesting. That might mean he knows where her ship is. But do we know where Charlie is?
He's disappeared. Last time anyone saw him, he was wet and had been underground, near Parliament.
Do you know anywhere like this, Mr. Plum?
Sounds like the drains. Vile place, dark, filthy and crawling with rats.
Sounds lovely. Who in their right mind would go down there?
Why do all these tunnels have to look the same?
Doctor, where are you?
Oh, fresh air. Well, at least that's better. A bit. What the heck was all that about?
Look, whoever you are, listen. We have to get out of here now.
I am Black Rod, Sergeant at Arms and Keeper of the Doors. Who are you and what are you doing here?
Yeah, later. Right now, you see those guys? Well, they are Sontarans, and they are very, very bad news. Come on.
Field Major Kash, I have a prisoner.
So, the human thinks it can subvert our plans here in this London city and report back to its Rutan masters that the Sontarans have discovered their plan.
Look, mate, I have no idea what you're talking about. I've never even heard of a Rutan.
Do not try to be clever with me, human. It will only cause you more pain. Why else would you be down here if you were not in the service of the Rutan host? We know their ship lies here somewhere.
Listen, maybe if you told me what was going on.
The Sontaran Empire has been at war with the Rutan host for 50,000 years. Every Sontaran is pledged to Sontar to seek out and destroy its enemies.
So what are the Sontarans doing in London?
We have detected the distress signal of a Rutan ship. A Rutan ship for which both the Empire and the host themselves have been searching for 400 years. It is somewhere near here.
400 years? What's so special about it?
It contains something of strategic value to both sides.
So, what's going to happen to me now?
Prisoners of war are always useful. For experimental purposes.
What?
We Sontarans pride ourselves in our lack of complacency. We are always looking for a better way to kill. Now, if you will excuse me, I have a Rutan ship to find. Watch him well.
What do you think you're doing? Sorry, there was a fly. It's a sewer. There are bound to be many flies. Now get back. What do you think you're doing? Get away from there. Sir, I am in your debt. The enchantment put upon me by those bald devils seems lifted.
Black Rod? Oh, is that your name? I knew a Ginger Gavin when I was a kid.
That is not my name, it is my title. I am the Gentleman Usher of the Black Rod to the Parliament of His Majesty King James I. I am charged with keeping the peace within the walls of Parliament and guarding its treasures and secrets from those traitors who would steal them away.
How did you get caught by the Sontarans?
I was investigating rumors of another plot to kill the king. Twice already there have been Catholic plots to remove him from the throne. There were whispers of a sinister presence in the halls beneath Parliament. When I came to search out the truth, I was confronted by those devils. And somehow they took me in their thrall.
They're not actually devils. They're called Sontarans. They come from another planet.
Another planet? I don't understand.
All you need to know is they're the enemy. King James, that's the Scottish one, yeah?
Indeed. King James was James VI of Scotland. Queen Elizabeth had no direct heirs, but James's great-grandmother was the elder sister of Henry VIII, and thus the succession passed to him.
Tell me more about Parliament.
The Parliament of England sits in the Palace of Westminster, and is formed of two houses, the Commons and the Lords. Each sit to discuss and ratify laws that are passed, as well as give assent when our monarch wishes to raise taxes.
What traitors would those be, then?
Threats to the crown come from many quarters. Spies of foreign nations and a threat from Catholics within our own borders is constant.
Spies? It's a bit early for James Bond, isn't it?
Bond? James Bond? You confuse me, sir. Is this man a spy?
Oh, it's all right. He's on our side.
These days, it is hard to be sure who is on whose side. England is wealthy and jealously coveted by our neighbors, and the Catholic threat is a constant danger to the realm.
All the Catholics I know are pretty harmless.
Many are harmless, of course. But their loyalties lie with the Pope in Rome, not with our monarch. And although James has taken measures for Catholic and Protestant to live in peace side by side, there are those who would see the rightful sovereign replaced with a Catholic monarch and puppet to the Pope.
Do you know how to get us out of here?
I do indeed. But we must proceed with caution. Follow me. Don't get spotted. Wait for my signal, then come towards me. Follow me. Nearly there. You're doing well.
Santa Ha!
Now, down this way and we shall be safe.
Where are we going? I have to get back to my wife and the doctor. He'll sort out what's going on here, I promise you.
Find your friends. Do your duty. Allow me to do mine. Protect the king's office.
That's beautiful.
The ceremonial mace. The symbol of our sovereign freedom. It must never fall into the hands of those bald devils below.
Right. Time to get this paper to the doctor. Those are the Sontarans.
Really? Well, thank you for pointing that out.
I was coming to tell you about them. According to Field Major Karsh, the crash ship is Rutan. They're at war against them.
Hang on, since when did you get so chatty with the Sontarans?
Yeah, well, they captured me.
Didn't get the paper, did they?
Ta-da! It's details of the plotters' meeting.
Really?
There's nothing there.
Oh, don't be so negative. Nothing there. Negative. Get it?
Anyway, I got the mind control device out of Blackrod's neck, and now he's hiding in his treasure room up in Parliament.
The treasure room?
It's behind a secret panel. The ceremonial mace and all this other stuff is in there.
Right. Well, let's see what secrets this piece of paper has for us.
Do you think it might be invisible ink?
Quite possibly. 10 out of 10, and a jammy dodger too for Amy. Alternatively, it might have a micromolecular encoding sequence, but that would need a subatomic televiewer to read. Luckily, this smells of lemons.
All this fuss over a blank piece of paper.
Is it blank? Or is it just that you can't see what's on it?
Doctor, I can see there's nothing on it.
That's what you think. Did you know that chickens can see in infrared light?
Good for them. But what's that got to do with anything?
You'll find out. Look at this. It reads, be at the Duck and Drake on London Bridge for 9 of the hour.
Are you really gonna go?
Yes. I feel a bout of infiltration coming on. Maybe even some dressing up. You two, on the other hand, have to find that Rutan ship before the Sontarans. And we have to get that ship off Earth to get rid of those lesions. Right, let's get on with it. That looks like Robert Catesby, the leader of the plotters.
Hello, I'm the Doctor.
We have nothing to say to you, stranger.
That Guy Fawkes, in the flesh. Hello, I'm the Doctor.
I don't know who you are or what you want, but you might find it healthy to keep your nose out of other people's business.
Hello, I'm the Doctor.
Welcome, brother, welcome. A brother of the true faith. How is King Philip?
Oh, he's in fine form. Always got a lovely tan. It's all that Spanish sun, I suppose, and the oranges and the paella. He does love his paella. Anyway, glad to be of service, Guido. I can call you that, can't I?
Sir, the timing of your arrival is good fortune itself, for the clock ticks, and there is a task at hand that requires one such as yourself.
And what task did you have in mind?
In a fit of healthy paranoia, believing I might be under suspicion by the King's men, I disposed of a reel of fuse wire over the parapet of the bridge. I heard no splash, so I believe it landed on the supports and so may be lodged there. If indeed I am being watched, then it would incriminate me and expose our entire endeavour, if I were seen to fetch it. But should you, good Doctor, make your way beneath the bridge and retrieve the fuse wire, our mission to remove the King will be safeguarded, and I would be eternally grateful. Have you found my fuse wire?
Where is the fuse powder?
It lies under the bridge. You can get down there via one of the cellars.
I was just wondering, how did a chap like you get mixed up in a plot to remove the King of England?
I was originally a son of York. Both my parents were Protestant, devoted worshippers in the English Church.
Then how come you're on the side of the Catholics?
My mother's family were Catholics, and when my father died, she married again. A Catholic. I converted to the faith of my mother's family and left for Europe, where I fought for Spain against the Dutch Protestants. That was where I learned the craft of gunpowder.
So that's your part of the plot. You're the explosives expert.
I am just a simple soldier, Doctor. I will set the fuse below Parliament and light it.
Tell me about the other conspirators.
We are a gathering of loyal Catholics from all walks of life. Robert Catesby is the instigator of the plan, and each of us has their role to play.
But don't you think murdering the King is going a bit far?
This is not murder. This is the work of God.
We are God's true soldiers in this endeavor. The Protestant monarchy and people of England have been condemning themselves to hellfire. What I do for the good of the nation and the souls of our people.
Here you go, Guido, your fuse wire.
Good sir, how may I serve you this evening?
Thomas Percy, one of the gunpowder plotters.
Hello, I'm the Doctor. Our business is of no concern to you, stranger. Hello, I'm the Doctor.
Impeccable credentials, sir. It is an honor to have you join us. I was wondering if you could do me a favor. Discreet favor.
And what favor would that be?
My job was to obtain a parliamentary seal. I was returning from the successful mission when some pickpocket called Barnaby had away with it. If you can retrieve it from the villain, then I would be most grateful. But above all, do not tell Catesby.
Tell me a little about yourself.
I am Thomas Percy. I have been many things in my time, a soldier and adventurer. Indeed, I even played my part in seating the Scottish king on our English throne.
Then why are you part of the plan to kill him?
Because James has reneged on his promises of tolerance towards the Catholics. I told Catesby a year ago I would kill the king with my own bare hands if I had the chance. He asked me to bide my time because he has a plan.
So tell me about your plan.
If you require detail, you should speak to Catesby. I do not concern myself with the minutiae of plans. I put my faith in God.
Hello, I'm the Doctor.
So our message reached King Philip.
Thank the Lord. You can be of great service to the cause. Well met. It is good to see an ally in these dangerous times.
If you truly believe in the cause, there is a small task you could do for me.
What do you want me to do?
Dealing with Parliament is only the first part of our plan. At the same time, we must secure a new monarch to place upon the throne of England. In order to achieve this, I need you to find me a sleeping draught.
Tell me a little about yourself.
There's little to tell. I was born a Catholic. I have known all my life the Protestant intolerance of those who worship in the true church. 4 years ago, I stood alongside the Earl of Essex in his rebellion against Queen Elizabeth.
The rebellion was a failure. What happened to you?
I was imprisoned and fined 4,000 marks. At which time, I was forced to sell my estate. I have been preparing for the removal of the Protestant monarch ever since.
So you're numero uno among the plotters, is that right?
I am the leader of this great venture. It was I who brought these like-minded fellows together, and it is I who drew up the plan.
And what is the plan?
On the morrow, the heretic James and his lackeys will, by the grace of God, be sent to their maker via several hundred pounds of powder that shall be lit when he arrives to open that den of vipers he calls a parliament. At the same time, the rest of us will ride for the Midlands, where we shall kidnap the Princess Elizabeth and proclaim her as our new Catholic queen. On hearing this, the hidden and oppressed Catholics shall rise up and flock to our banner. Without its leaders, the Protestant will be cast down.
Why this plot? Why now?
Because enough is enough. I do not do this for glory or profit. I do it because it is just and right.
Good evening, sir. I am Alice Flowers, purveyor of fine herbs, remedies, and other wards against pox, pestilence, and ill vapours in these dark times.
Hello, Alice. I'm the doctor. How is business?
As long as plague and pestilence haunt the land, there will always be a call for my medicines.
What pestilences are about?
The flux. And the sweating sickness is ever present in London. But what we truly fear is a return of the plague. Fortunately, I have the remedies to cure or ease many of these ailments.
What do you know about the plague?
We must be ever vigilant for signs of the plague. Not 50 years ago, it took almost a quarter of all souls in London. Since then, by God's grace, the outbreaks have been much less severe. Yet when it comes, there's no hiding from its deadly touch. Not for anyone, young or old, rich or poor.
What remedies do you sell?
Many herbs, sir, in preparations to relieve all kinds of maladies.
Say I had, I don't know, a toothache. What would you prescribe?
Primrose root in vinegar. Snuffed up the nose works a treat. Or there's sneeze wart, or crowfoot, and chewy mustard seed will do it too. I have them all here, sir. Everything but leeches.
Leeches?
Those who are very sick should take a regular course of bleeding. But that is a surgeon's work, not mine.
Well, happily, I'm perfectly healthy.
It is quite safe and healthy. And leeches are only used on those afraid of the physician's lancet.
I'm looking for something to help me sleep.
I can mix you such a draught, but I require the leaf of valerian. Bring some to me.
You ain't getting your hands on me!
Hello again, Doctor.
I'm looking for something to help me sleep.
I already told you. I can mix you such a draught, but I require the leaf of valerian. Bring some to me. Just put the herbs into the bowl so I can give it a good mix. There you go, my dear. A draught that would knock out the devil himself.
Well met again, Doctor, sir. I hope there are no more sorcerous gates giving you problems. You must excuse me. I must be on my way.
You're gonna have to try harder than that to catch me! You've got to be faster than that! Stop following me! Stay away from me! Let me go!
Not until you hand over something that isn't yours.
I didn't do nothing! Let me go, or I'll get the watch on you!
I think they'll be rather more interested in you than me. You and the parliamentary seal you stole, so give it to me, or...
All right. Here you go.
Hear ye, hear ye. King James to open Parliament on the morrow.
One sleeping potion. Don't drink it all at once.
Excellent. You are truly dedicated to the cause.
I think this is what you've been looking for, and don't worry, Catesby doesn't suspect a thing.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
For these favours, the new Catholic England will be most grateful. You must join us later for our final preparations in the Duck and Drake. Four raps on the door will allow you entry to our gathering. There, the full scope of our plans will be revealed.
This stuff glows like Lady Winter's eyes.
Is that what Rutans are made from?
Could be. They are horrible. Big glowing jelly things. There's loads of this stuff around here.
Which means that Lady Winter's can't be too far away.
How are we going to get past this one? It doesn't look like there's a way around.
I'll think of something. Maybe I can get as far as that bridge when he's not looking.
Easy. You went down like a sack of spuds. I thought some Sontarans were tough.
The plank whacked him here, right on the back of the neck.
That is handy to know.
It looks like someone else has figured out how to deal with some Sontarans.
Could it be the Rutan?
Could be.
But when did the Rutan start using marbles?
That's it. That's the ship we're after. I just hope no one's at home.
Me too. Ladies first.
Well, this doesn't look healthy.
Well, best not to stay static. Just charge it. Get it?
Is that a joke? Maybe I'll just pretend it was just buzzing in my ears.
This looks important. All the pipes and tubes seem to join up here, into that thing in the middle.
And it looks like it's still busy repairing itself from the crash. It moves right here.
Wait,
I recognize that noise.
Get down! My stupid face! Get behind some cover!
It doesn't actually seem interested in me. Perhaps it took issue with your breath sense.
I could have been killed there. It's not funny. Well, if you're not too busy watching this thing try to fry me, perhaps you could do something.
Okay, let me figure something out.
Any idea why it doesn't like you?
I don't know. My musical taste? Maybe my terrible choice in husband. Perhaps it's something I'm carrying. Or something you're carrying that makes you appear as a friend. Why on earth do I want that? Oh, slimy.
Yes, but like you said, it's the stuff the Rutans are made from. Well, there's your answer.
It looks organic.
Yeah. And not only that, but some of it looks fresh. New.
New growth. Like it's been repairing itself. Maybe it's getting ready to take off.
Wonder what this is. It looks sort of familiar.
And it looks like there's another one missing.
Did you hear that?
We'll have you free soon. Are you Charlie?
Yeah? Who are you?
I'm Amy, and this is my husband Rory. We've been looking for you.
Why? I ain't done nothing. You be careful with that.
Keep still.
How can I keep still when you're about to cut me open?
Shh. So, you're Charlie.
What if I am? You're two of them, aren't you? The green monsters.
No, you're safe.
Yeah, of course I am.
Hey!
Well, he certainly knows how to take out Sontarans. He's got guts anyway.
He's going to have trouble if he runs into them again without these.
Maybe, but at least we don't have to sneak around Karsh and his men anymore. Time for some David and Goliath action.
Better talk to the doctor. I wonder how he's getting on with Guy Fawkes and the other plotters.
Looks like it's time to roll out the barrel, even if it is full of gunpowder.
All this planning is thirsty work, I can tell you that. The Dock and Drake is an excellent place in which to discuss our next move. You and your stomach, Guy. God forbid that you should ever be separated from it. God forbid any of us should be separated from our guts. I dare not think what the King's men would do to us should they learn of our plans.
You men should be thinking of victory, not failure. No doubt that is what you will drink to later.
Doctor?
Guido, me old mate.
Hush! Do you want to bring King James's spies down on us? Come in.
Hello, hello. Hello, I'm the Doctor.
Allow me to introduce Lady Elizabeth Winters.
Delighted to make your acquaintance, my lady. I hope we can be friends.
It seems we are all conspirators here, Doctor.
So, to business.
Everything is prepared for tomorrow's opening of Parliament?
There are 41 kegs of powder installed in the Undercroft.
Wouldn't 36 be enough?
Fawkes fought for the Spanish. He has adequate experience in the arts of gunpowder, Doctor.
Oh, of course. Ignore me.
Fawkes will stay with the barrels tonight and prepare the fuse. We others shall ride for Warwickshire to drug the young Princess Elizabeth. When James is dead, we shall install her on the throne in the eyes of God. Once married to a Catholic, she will be our rightful queen.
After the fuse is lit, I shall escape across the Thames by boat and make my way to Flanders to explain our actions and intentions to the European courts.
May God preserve us in his undertaking. And God save our new Catholic queen.
Our queen!
Killing you would be so easy, Doctor.
Hardly worth bothering then, as I only want to help you.
Your name echoes across the universe, Time Lord. Why would you help the Rutans?
Well, because I'm partly responsible for your ship being buried under Parliament. It was my TARDIS you ran into 400 years ago. Also, because your ship being there is causing a dimensional disturbance across London, and because the Sontarans know you're here, and I don't want anyone getting caught in the crossfire.
And what of the English King and his Parliament?
The King won't die. Parliament won't be destroyed. I won't have you hijacking the gunpowder plot, messing up the timeline, and robbing kids of 400 years of bonfire nights.
After so long in suspension, our engines require the kinetic momentum of the explosion to engage. So how can we launch with that building above us?
I can help you. Because believe me, I want you gone.
Doctor, are you all right?
Ah, Pons, allow me to introduce Lady Elizabeth Winters, Rutan of this parish. Did you find her ship?
Yes.
Then so can the Sontarans. You don't have much time.
When the ship crashed, we lost two energy conversion rods. Without them, the ship can't launch. But the rods are indestructible. It must be close by.
Sounds like a job for the Ponds.
Glowing rods on London Bridge. Why do we always get the good jobs?
Stop complaining. We've got a job to do. Where to start?
Up there, isn't the hand of that clock glowing?
Yeah, but where's the other one?
Look down there.
Hey, result!
Okay, next time, you go low and I'll go high.
But you said heights bothered you.
Yeah, but I'd rather be a bit scared than covered in wet, cold mud.
So none of this would have happened but for your infernal TARDIS. 400 years my crew has been in suspended animation, Doctor.
Well, we can all do with a good lie-in once in a while.
Halt!
No! Stop it! Stop it! There was absolutely no need for that.
What does it matter? It was a Sontaran. They'll clone another 20 just like him.
All life matters.
Yes. Well, if your stupid craft hadn't stopped us, the issue would be irrelevant.
I guess we just put them in here.
Come on, let's get out of here.
What do you mean, irrelevant?
The friends have brought my ship back to life.
What do you mean, irrelevant?
We were on our way to the ceremonial annihilation of the entire Sontaran species.
Ceremonial annihilation? Rutans have a pretty perverted sense of pageantry.
Our ship carried two doomsday weapons. Genetic bombs that would wipe the Sontarans from existence and end 10,000 years of war. One was lost in the crash, but all we need is that which remains. And now we will soon be free to use it. Thank you, Doctor.
Stop!
Doctor! Satan shakes the earth in rage at our rightful quest! But he shall not stop us! Come, help me!
Yes, I think I better.
Follow me, Doctor. We must check on the powder. If it is spoiled, all our plans will be undone.
Hold on there, Guido. Slow down.
Ah! There you are, Guido. Are you all right?
By the grace of God, yes. But the corridor is blocked. And there is no other exit from here.
Don't worry. I'll think of something. Now, what do we have here? There's several tons of gunpowder in the other room. I'm going to have to be very careful where I point this cannon.
Nearly there. I'll be glad when we're far away from Parliament. Run! Amy, this way! Faster!
Forty-one kegs. Five of them need to be moved next door into that room. And that's where you should light the fuse.
What is this? You seek to tell me my own business?
No. Just make sure things are done properly. Look, trust me. We'll need 36 barrels of gunpowder in here. Oh, and you need to set the fuse now.
Now? King James doesn't arrive until the morrow.
Listen to me, Guido, Guy, whichever. I have information that the King has come to Parliament tonight for a secret meeting. You must set the fuse now.
Doctor!
No time!
The Houses of Parliament are about to be blown into orbit.
Okay, they're what? What did you just do?
Pretty neat, don't you think? The gunpowder explodes, the Rutan ship takes off. Meanwhile, Parliament is transported up here out of harm's way just for a millisecond, and no one's the wiser.
Is that the Rutans?
Yes, that'll be them.
It looks like they're coming this way.
Doctor, where is the Doomsday weapon?
I have no idea. Have you lost it? You know, you really can't be too careful with Doomsday weapons.
Your friends have taken it. And now we're coming to take it back.
We don't know anything about any weapon, okay?
Surrender it, or we will destroy you all.
Get off me!
Well, what do we have here?
I'm a boy. Question is, what the hell are you, a flaming goblin?
Field Major Kash, the Avix Patrol has come under Rutan attack.
So, they have returned. Perhaps the weapon is still here. We may yet have a chance to turn the tables on the Rutan host. Question him.
It's gotta be that orb thing that Charlie ran off with. That must be the Doomsday weapon.
Thing is, it looked familiar.
Familiar?
When I was at Black Rod's treasure room, there's an orb just like it set in the ceremonial mace.
Of course you did. The Rutans lost a second Doomsday weapon when they crashed here. It's quite pretty for a weapon. Someone decided to incorporate it in the mace.
And we think we know who has the other one.
Charlie, yes, I heard.
You heard? You weren't even in the room.
Sound carries in the TARDIS. Have you never noticed that? I hear everything.
You hear everything?
I sometimes wear earplugs. Now, catch.
And this is...
It emits an electromagnetic pulse that will stun the Rutans. However, it'll need fixing before you go around pointing it at anything.
And where are you off to now?
We need to find both Doomsday weapons before either the Rutans or the Sontarans.
The Sontarans?
Of course, you don't think they'd be so worried about just any Rutan ship buried under Parliament, do you? They knew about the Doomsday weapons. If they get their hands on one, they could adapt it to destroy the Rutans. Exactly as the Rutans were going to destroy them.
Maybe we should just leave them to it.
We can't. Never mind the immorality of genocide, we have to get Parliament back to Earth, and we can't do that with Sontarans and Rutans marching, stroke, floating about.
So we've got to find Charlie.
You find Charlie, I'm going to find Black Rod.
We should split up. We'll cover more ground faster.
Thank you.
So much for transporting the Parliament having harm to land. The poor kiddies are really going to have their hands full when this world finishes.
Find Charlie, let's split up. Why does it always end up with me getting shot at?
Where is the Rutan weapon?
I don't know what you're on about. I want to go home. My sister Annie, she's sick.
I know it's been a difficult day with aliens and Parliament floating in space and everything, but believe me, I've got a plan, and it's a good plan. And this is part of the plan, my very, very good plan, if you just put the sword down so the plan doesn't come to an abrupt and frankly messy end, and I'll explain everything.
Sir, I've had my mind lost to hairless devils, been attacked by giant orbs of flying light, and been blasted into the ether by plotters determined to kill my sovereign. The only thing of which I am sure is the yard of cold steel in my hand, and my determination to run it through your gizzard.
Well, since you put it like that, I can, of course, sense the tension in the room. And tension is never good, not when a lot of it is humming down the blade of a sword. So, tell me, what can I do to turn this around and gain your trust?
The mace, the ceremonial mace you carry, is actually an alien doomsday device that could potentially destroy the world and the entire Suntaran species with it. Please, hand it over so I can disarm it.
Such strange words. Such strange claims. You are either telling the truth, or a greater spinner of yarns than Bill Shakespeare himself.
The orb on the ceremonial mace you carry, it's not what you think it is. Where did it come from?
The orb? It was dug from the ground that this great palace was built upon.
I thought so. And you can have no idea what it really is.
What it really is? You seek to mystify me with distraction.
The orb is a device that's come from another world, from beyond the stars in your sky. It is a doomsday weapon designed to destroy an entire species. And I have to disarm it.
Look at it. Does anything you've ever seen in this world glow like that?
Indeed. It glows with an unearthly light. What you say may be the truth, or it may be sorcery. Truth be known, anything is possible after what I've seen this day.
Oh, you humans always running around threatening each other with pointy things. Why don't you just put that sword down and we can discuss this like grown-ups?
How dare you address me thus? Prepare to meet your maker!
If you kill me, the king won't stand a chance.
The king? What do you know of the king?
He is in grave danger.
This I know. A letter was sent to Lord Salisbury, a warning of a Catholic plot. Yet, this is only knowledge to Salisbury and his agents. Or the plotters themselves.
You see this? This, my friend, is a sonic screwdriver. And it's one of the most feared weapons in the whole universe. Ah, and unless you put that sword down, its strange whiny noise will be the last thing you hear.
Your trinkets don't scare me. Defend yourself!
The bald devils you saw, they're Sontarans, and they want your mace too. But believe me, they're nothing like as reasonable as I am. They won't ask you, they'll take it, and they're coming armed to the teeth. And your sword just won't stop them.
I doubt that. These Sultanas are no match for cold English steel.
Of course, the letter, the Monteagle letter. Of course you'll have seen it by now.
What trickery is this? How could you know of the letter?
William Parker, Baron Monteagle. He received an anonymous letter, didn't he? Warning him to stay away from Parliament. And, as a good Englishman, he showed it to Salisbury.
Your knowledge of events is indeed extensive. But still, these things fail to satisfy me on which side your allegiances lie.
I'm not here to fight. I'm here to sort this mess out, if you'll let me.
Enough of your prattle!
I guarantee you, sir, Lord Salisbury will be really disappointed if you run me through.
Speak not of those of whom you know nothing, knave!
Lord Robert Cecil, 1st Earl of Salisbury, spymaster to King James, defender of England, and Bob to his friends, and Bob to me. Run me through, and you'll really get Bob annoyed.
Your silver tongue spins a fine tale, sir. But you will have to try harder than that to save your skin.
I'm one of Salisbury's agents. Codename, the Doctor.
This may be the case. But how am I to know? You may be a double agent, sir.
No, really. Double agents, triple agents. I had enough of that in the 50s. It gets quite confusing after a while.
You know much of the current situation. Perhaps you speak the truth. Can you prove this?
I have my credentials right here. Just let me show them to you.
I apologize. I truly do, sir. But I hope you understand my predicament.
Ah, come. And you've brought a gun. You really shouldn't have.
Flags are pieces of lightweight cloth that can be raised to fly in the breeze. Both England and Scotland have their own flags. England's a red cross on a white background. The Scottish flag, a diagonal white cross on blue. When King James VI of Scotland became King James I of England as well, he proposed a merging of the two designs, which would eventually be known as the Union Flag.
Well, it almost looks like a sort of gun. Okay, here we are again. You're not a nurse, you're an action hero. You're not a nurse, you're an action hero.
Say hello, little friend. Hasta la vista, baby.
Oh, hello. I know what you are.
You will stand still and await the arrival of Field Major Karsh. I'll be eliminated.
Doctor?
You will be silent, or you will be eliminated.
Ah. How dare you come in here? The king will hear of this, I assure you. And when he does, he will descend upon you devils with the full weight of the English crown.
I said... silence.
I hate violence, but a good whack on the back of the head is the only language a Sontaran understands. Now let's take a look at this mace.
By Jesus! What witchcraft is this?
No witchcraft, just highly sophisticated tri-quantum physics. Now, a little hush, please. These things can be quite tricky, and if I make a slip-up, there probably won't be a great deal left of this corner of the galaxy. Wipe out a species with this. Thank you for your help. Ah, and don't come out until you feel the earth shake again.
Happily.
Get off me!
You will be silent, or you will be eliminated.
There is no way I can take on both of these Sontarans. Okay, I need to distract them.
Right.
Yes, Mace. And to think I thought you were one of them.
Where is the Rutan weapon?
I don't know. I swear.
Then you have no strategic value.
Amy! Amy! He shoots, he scores.
My last marble. I better make it count. You called, my lady?
We've got to find the doctor.
Isn't this cozy?
We will take the Doomsday weapon.
The weapon is ours. Give it to me.
Oh, listen to you. You're like a bunch of kids. Mind you, anyone that's going to wage war on each other for 10,000 years is worse than kids.
We fight for the honor of Santa.
Santa, ha!
Do you know what I think? I don't think any of you can even remember what you went to war over in the first place.
Give me the Doomsday weapon, Doctor.
This? You want this? Or how about this?
The second weapon. You found it.
There are two?
Two Doomsday weapons. The dictionary definition of overkill, if you ask me. Or look at it another way. Plenty to go round. Why not have one each? One to wipe out the Sontarans, the other reset to destroy the entire Rutan host.
What treachery is this?
I prefer to call it stalemate. Go ahead. Activate your weapon. But you'll never know. You might be killing your own species.
Sontaran's laugh.
That one does.
A brilliant strategy, Doctor. You have rendered both devices ineffective. Once more, war is honorable.
War is never honorable, Field Major Karsh.
This device could have ended the bloodshed of 10 millennia, Doctor, in an instant. How many millions more lives have you now sentenced to a bloody death?
I could end the war right now. I could activate both weapons, destroy both species in an instant. And maybe you deserve it.
No!
Genocide is no solution to a war, even between Sontarans and the Rutan host. Now push off before I change my mind.
Doctor, that... was brilliant.
Thank you. And for my next trick, putting Parliament back where it belongs before anyone notices.
What about Guy Fawkes?
I left him in a locked room with 36 barrels of gunpowder. And soon it'll be midnight.
Doctor! What has taken place? The door was jammed. Or locked. By God's own grace alone, I have survived. What news of the king?
He's still alive.
Then we have failed.
You still have 36 barrels of gunpowder. Your place in history is assured.
There is still a chance.
Oh, believe me, they will light bonfires in your name for centuries to come. People will know this as Guy Fawkes Night.
Do you think so?
You have a part to play in history. Play it well, Guido.
Open up! Open up in the name of King James!
Remember the 5th of November. Gunpowder, treason and plot. I see no reason why gunpowder treason should ever be forgot.